dear students, in this session we are going to discuss about the summary of organization level symmetry body cavity. So the kingdom Animalia includes different levels of organizations. So those are cellular level of organization, tissue level of organization, organ level of organization, and organ system level of organization. So let us discuss about the cellular level of organization. So which organism body is composed of many cells, that type of organization is called a cellular level of organization. That means the organism consists multiple cells in the body. So here the cellular level of organization exhibits only porifera such as sponges. So here the phylum Porifera consists number of cells in the body, but it does not consist tissue level of organization, because the sensory and nerve cells are absent in the body of sponges. So next one, tissue level of organization means the presence of nerve cells and sensory cells, the coordination among themselves, and constitute a different types of cells can perform different types of functions is called tissue level of organization. So here tissue level of organization exhibited by the cnidarians and tenosynovians. Organ system level of organization means different types of tissues fuse together and form a organ. So different types of organs can perform different types of functions. That type of level of organization is called organ level of organization. So organ level of organization exhibited by the platyhelminthes. So last one, organ system level of organization. So different types of organs are associated and perform single function. That type of level of organization is called organ system level of organization. So this type of level of organization exhibited from annelida to chordate. So here the symmetry, if we consider the symmetry, which animal passes the cellular level of organization? Those organisms do not consist of symmetry. Hence here the symmetry divided into majorly two types. Those are radial symmetry, second one is the bilateral symmetry. So here radial symmetry means if we dissect an organism by any polar axis, it can give two equal antimeres is called radial symmetry. So here cnidaria and Tenophora phyla exhibit radial symmetry. So there is body cavity is not lined in the body of cnidarians and Tenophorans. Hence here the body cavity concept is not there in the cnidaria and Tenophora. Right. Second one is the bilateral symmetry. That means if we dissect an organism by only one polar axis, it can give two equal antimeres is called bilateral symmetry. So here all bilateral symmetrical organisms are triploblastic organisms. That's why the mesoderm can form a cavity. So that cavity is called as coelom. So coelom can be divided into majorly three types. Those are acoelom, pseudocoelom, and eucoelom. So acoelom means the absence of coelom. The cavity does not lining between the body wall and elementary canal is called acoelom. Acoelom means the cavity not lying between the body wall and elementary canal is called a coelom. So which animal passes this type of coelom? Those are called coelomates. So platyhelminthes exhibit a coelom. So second one is the pseudo coelom. Pseudo means false. So the cavity lying between the body wall and elementary canal, but the cavity is filled with the pseudo coelic fluid, hence it is called pseudo coelom. Which animal passes this type of coelom? Those are called pseudo coelomates. So nematoda, phyla organisms exhibit pseudo coelom. Right, third one is the eucoelom. Eucoelom considered as true coelom. It can be divided into again two types. Those are schizocoelom and enterocoelom. Schizocoelom means the cavity is formed by the splitting of mesoderm is called schizocoelom. Annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, phyla are exhibited schizocoelom. Last one, enterocoelom, that means the cavity is formed by the mesodermal pouches is called enterocoelom. So enterocoelom exhibited by the echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata phyla organisms. So here the classification is obtained based on the organization, symmetry and the body cavity. So this is the process of classification into the phyla.